Dave?
Hey, yes.
How are you? It's Kelly.
Hey, Kelly. How are you doing besides being really busy?
Good. It's a good problem to have, though. I'm doing well. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. You're right about being a good problem. It's great. It's great talking to you. This is awesome. On the very same day that, is this episode 4 of season 2 of I Love Kelly Pickler tonight?
Yeah, look at you. You know your stuff.
Yes.
You're on top of it. Yeah, we are so excited to see tonight's episode, and we're going to get some of the cast members together before I hit the road tonight and watch the show, and then I hop on the bus and head to North Carolina for a concert. And then I'll be headed your way not too long.
You're exactly right. Saturday, October 1st, Beaver Dam Amphitheater. Down in Ohio County, and we're excited about that. I tell you, when we got the news that you were going to be here, and then we put that up on WBKR.com,
thank you so much. We're looking forward to it. We're going to have a good time.
People went bananas. You're going to love the amphitheater. It's a great time of the year to be doing a concert there, and we're very excited about it. And by the way, people can get tickets at beaverdamtourism.org. But let's talk about the success of this great show, I Love Kelly Pickler. The world of reality TV welcomed you with open arms, and you just took a big bite out of it. It's awesome.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much. We've been so blessed, and my husband and I were so blessed to have great people in our lives, and we get to document our fun memories that we make with our friends and with each other, and put it out for the world to see and experience the journey along with us. So it's really been great. I mean, we were shocked that season one took off the way that it did, and we, got the call about we're picking you up for season 2, and we've just had even more fun this year, and we're just keeping our fingers crossed for season 3.
That's exciting. That's exciting. You know, you said at the beginning of the conversation you're headed to North Carolina for a concert. I was wondering how you strike this balance between doing the show and hitting the road and recording.
You know, it's crazy trying to juggle it all and then be a wife at the same time.
Well,
you know,
yeah,
and
that's right.
Be home. So we just really have to schedule everything. Our life is one big schedule, which is not bad. It's a good thing. It's a good problem to have, like we were saying earlier.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, we took quite a bit of break from the road. I didn't do as many tour dates this summer as what I would have loved to have done,
mm-hmm.
but that was because we were filming
right.
and whatnot. So that took us almost 4 months of just putting the show together. And which is crazy. I didn't realize, you know, I've done television before, but I've never had my own personal show. So I didn't realize the hours and, you know, just the time and the commitment and the other things that you have to give up in order to do this. So I'm hoping that the show will just help everything else that's going on and
yes.
Whatnot. But I'm happy to be back out on the road for the rest of the year. And we've got some fun things planned.
That's exciting. What about recording?
I would love to get back in the studio as soon as possible. I just went in and recorded a Christmas song for my Selma Dry interior line that's inspired by my great-grandmother, Selma.
Oh, nice.
So, yeah, we do a Christmas song every year with the line, and it's a special little added, I guess, bonus in the collection. So that's what I've got coming up this fall and winter, and then hopefully get back in the studio when things slow down and get some new music out.
It's
wonderful.
Speaking of music, can you believe it's been 10 years since the release of Red High Heels?
Isn't that crazy? Time doesn't slow down for nobody, does it?
That's exactly
no,
right.
No, it's so wild to think, you know, I was 19 and green when I got in line for American Idol, and, you know, time has just flew by, and I think about the girl at 19 writing that song with Chris Lindsey and Amy Mayo and Karen Rochelle. And we wrote that song over the telephone, actually.
Oh, that's great.
And yeah, we did. And I think I was in the middle of the American Idol tour when we wrote that song. And it's crazy to go back and reflect on those times, you know, because songs have a way of, taking you places, whether it's your past or wherever, memory lane.
Oh my gosh, they're the most evocative things out there. I can hear a song from when I was a kid, and I can go exactly where I was the first time I heard it. You're exactly
Oh
right.
yeah, it's the same with like scents and smells, you know?
Right,
it's like
right.
you can smell someone's cologne or perfume, and it'll remind you of someone that you met 20 years ago.
The power of music. Power of music.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, speaking of time flying, before you know it, it's going to be October 1st, and you're going to be on stage at the Beaver Dam Amphitheater. We're really excited about you coming to the area.
Well, thank you very much. We're looking forward to it. We have a good time everywhere we go, so we're going to bring the party with us.
Fantastic. BeaverDamTourism.org, gang, that's where you go to get tickets. And Kelly Pickler, it has been delightful talking to you.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you, baby. We'll talk soon.
All right. Good luck with the show. Thanks.
Thank you, honey. See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye, honey.